Okay, so I'm making this video because in hopes that it will help somebody else. This is the original iron for this plane. It's worn down and it has a defect in it that you may not be able to see. There are some very deep grooves right here that are causing problems. And so I've never had this problem before. I've probably had 15 of these planes over the years, and I've never had this problem. I've worn these original irons. Like, I've never replaced an iron before. So I hauled off and I bought the Lee Valley iron that is 0.1 inches thick. So it's 100 thousandths thick, and it's sharpened at 30 degrees, whatever. And this is a special hardened steel. I haven't messed with this much. I did hone it. And I took the corners off of the iron so that it wouldn't leave plane tracks everywhere. So the long and the short of this is just a scrap of wood that I have here. I don't know if you can see that. I may need to, yeah. Okay, so you can sort of see that. Long and the short of this is that this thing, it planes, but the mouth on here is so damn small that there's not much you can do with it. This also right now is not set up. Like, I haven't made the plane. I don't have the lateral adjustment on it, but it's not working real well. It either takes a huge shaving or a small shaving, and then it gets all clogged up in here. You can see how small the opening is for the chip to run through. So what they say is that 80% of the plane, 80% of planes will do fine with this iron and 20% won't. Well, this must be part of the 20%. I moved the frog as far back as I could. So there's that. I also cleaned all the dust and junk out of there. I'm kind of at a loss. So I looked up what other people are doing, and what they'll do is they'll take the mouth of the plane and file it open. So that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm a little hesitant to do that. This is a Keen Cutter number 4, which is nothing. This is not a terribly special plane to anybody except me. I think this thing works great. This is one of my favorite pieces that I have around the shop. And I don't want to ruin it. I'm real hesitant to open up the mouth, but I'm really curious about this iron. And frankly, I could get another one of these if I wanted to. This plane, I don't even know. I don't know really anything about it. I don't know how old it is. I've had it for about 5 years, and I have used the living bejesus out of it. You can see that I've modified the heel a little bit. About once a year, I'll spend some time with a stone and flatten it out a bit. Take the burrs off. It does have some initials right here. I guess I'll hold that the way you can see it. I think that's a JOS. I don't love that that's on the side of the plane, but whatever. It's not that big of a deal. Anyway, I'm going to put this in the vise, which I really don't like putting planes in the vise. They need to be clamped very gently if you do that, because you will, I guess I'll pull this out so I can show you, but you can break the wings off really, really easily. This is just ductile iron, or it's cast iron, right? And it's only about 100 thousandths thick, so this will break right here. Ask me how I know. Anyway, so this is going in the vise, okay? And it's firm in there, but not, you know, we're not making this, it's not gorilla tight. So let's get a file. Okay, here's my file. This is actually a little bit loaded up with wood. This is a double cut file, which I'm not super stoked about using on this, but it's what I've got right now. So what I'm going to do, I think I want to file about 30 thousandths off of here. So I'm just using the Sharpie as some bluing. I do keep Dykem around my shop, but I don't like to use it unless I absolutely have to because shit goes everywhere. All I'm going to do here, this is not perfect, this is not ideal even, but I just want to give myself a guideline. So I'm going to set, this to about 30 thousandths to start. And that may not be enough, but I can always take more later. So 30 thousandths. And I'm just going to take, and if I can get it in there. Okay. So I scribed a line across there. I don't know if you can see that or not. I think you can. And I'm going to file. Normally I would do this in a little different position. As a matter of fact, I think I'm gonna. When you go in the vise. I don't know if you can see that or not. I'm trying to kind of be even about this, but it wasn't real even from the get-go. And I don't think, with these planes, I don't think that there's much that... They don't do much finish machining on the casting. It's not like a modern plane, like a Lee Nielsen or something. I'm sure there will be comments on this that people will say, oh, I'm going both directions with the file and I'll wear out my file. My response to that is what files are for, is to wear them out. They're to be used. Oops, that's not good. I think there are some of you that will make the argument that I should just go ahead and get out a Dremel or a die grinder or something like that. I think that is categorically a bad idea for a whole bunch of reasons. One is this is a hand tool shop. We use hand tools here. The other reason is that I can't see how I would keep this straight with a rotary tool unless I had a mill. And I think if you have access to a mill, I think go ahead and do it. Take a cut on it. But I don't have a mill here. Got a drill press that I almost never use. Milling on a drill press sucks. Okay, so I think we're getting real close here. right. So that feels nice and smooth. There's no burr on there. I am gonna just, okay. Let's see what happens. Crap off the iron. Okay, that already looks better. See that? Can you see the light coming through there? That already looks better. All right, let's give this a shot. Here's that piece of wood that I had before. This has a little buffing compound on it. Not the best thing to plane into, but okay. Oh, that feels better already. I recently saw a thing on Stumpy Nubs that was a, I gotta put glasses on here. It was like this micrometer for plane depth, plane iron depth. And I would love to play with that. Anybody ever played with one of those? Okay, get rid of these glasses. Oh, that's way too deep. Still too deep. Okay, it's taking a good shaving now. Oh, that's so much better. Okay, so there's a shaving about, 6/1000ths of an inch. And that shaving is about, maybe 12. Just a little lateral adjustment there. Yeah, that's much better. Cool. Nice, even, clean shaving. That makes me happy. It actually goes that way. No, it doesn't. It goes this way. That is where it came from, right there. Anyway, anybody has any questions, holler at me. That wasn't as actually bad as I thought. I have to play with this plane a little, do a couple projects with it, but that makes me quite happy that that was really not that big of a deal at all. And I don't know, would that take me 3 or 4 minutes? Maybe 5? Cool. See you guys later. Okay, so it's now, 24 hours after I made that first video, and I've had some time to work with this plane a little bit. I'm really glad that I opened up that mouth. This thing is wonderful. It's a very light shaving right there. It's fantastic. It does not chatter. And if you take a little time and don't go so fast, it makes beautiful shavings, and your depth of cut can be quite deep. So I'm really glad that I did this. This is that same piece of maple. This is a fairly hard piece of wood. A little chatter right there on the end. Yeah, so, I mean, you can hog a hell of a lot of material off with that. It's stiff, it works great. I'm really glad I did this. So, anyway, just thought I'd report back. This plane has performed really well for me over the years, and I really like it a lot. And this has actually just made it better. I was kind of thinking about replacing it. I was actually thinking about ordering up a Lee Nielsen. I have a couple of Lee Nielsen tools, but they're so expensive that they're just cost prohibitive. They're not in the cards for me. But I do use a number 4 plane a lot. So anyway, food for thought, I guess, if you need a new plane iron or if you want to upgrade your plane. One of the things that they did not have was the chip breaker. They make this kind of pretty, it's almost 100,000ths thick as well, I think, chip breaker that does not have this in it. It's all one solid piece. I'm curious to try that, so maybe that'll be my next upgrade or whatever. But anyway, I'm really glad that I filed out this body. Another thing, just that I'll mention real quick, I've been buying these are bench dogs that are effectively disposable. I don't use a lot of dogging system, but I do on this vise, and then over there, over on that side of the bench, I have a tail vise, which I won't show you right now because it's kind of a mess in here. I've been working, but the plastic bench dogs are cool because if you hit them with a plane or a chisel or whatever, I don't know if you can see or not, but I certainly have hit this one with a plane right there. It doesn't take apart your edge. Anyway, hope y'all have a good day.